in the headlines. Chiefs and people of Georgia celebrate Georgia Bazaar. World Maritime Day observed with focus on safety on the water lake. Hello, good evening. Welcome to the studios of GBC24 and GTV. It's going to be 30 minutes of news. Thanks for joining us. My name is Micheline Taka. The Georgia area in the Ketu North constituency is to become an oil palm hub in the country. Government finds wisdom in request made by the traditional rulers to invest more in oil palm cultivation in the Georgia area to boost the business climate of the place. This was indicated during the Georgia Bazaar Festival, attended by dignitaries including President John Mahama.
An occasion for the traditional rulers. They are thrust to the fore, and their subjects exalt them to project the community's unique culture. Georgia Bazaar Festival of the Chiefs and the People of Georgia Traditional Area of the Volta Region brings indigenes together. This was the import of this year's festival, which included a call for peace and development. The item being projected by the people of Georgia is oil palm. They want government to invest heavily in oil palm by creating a plantation and assisting smallholder farmers who are already cultivating the crop. Among the dignitaries who attended the festival were President John Mahama, the Speaker of Parliament, Mr. Do Ajahu, and the National Security Advisor to the President, Alhaji Baba Kamara. The new patriotic party was represented by its vice presidential nominee, Dr. Mahamadou Bawumia, and a former Volta regional minister who served in the Kufo administration, Mr. Kwesi Jabesi. Culture and tradition were unfurled to entertain the gathering. Mr. Prosper Ledi read a speech on behalf of the Georgia Traditional Council.
The next step we have taken is to register Georgia Bazaar as agriculture festival to be recognized in the whole Ghana and beyond.
President John Mahama announced a series of interventions for Georgia in its environs, roads, schools, health facilities, and agriculture.
As part of our efforts to diversify the Ghanaian economy so that it is not reliant on a narrow basket of commodities, we're going to look at oil palm as a major, major investment area in order to help diversify our economy. Again, in our manifesto, which was launched in Sunyani on the 17th of September, if you go in the manifesto, oil palm is identified as one of the major investment areas that government is going to pump a lot of money in order to make Ghana self-sufficient in oil palm production.
Government officials, President John Mahama, and the opposition New Patriotic Party made contributions to a fundraising into the development portfolio of Georgia. Napoleon Atukitu reporting.
The Volta Lake claims lots of lives in boating accidents every year. According to the Ghana Maritime Authority, many of the victims could have been saved if they wore life jackets while traveling on the lake. In contrast, boat operators and the passengers commuting from Tepa Abatuase into neighboring communities seem unaware of the importance of wearing life jackets. GBC 24 was at Tepa Abatuase in the Volta region and brings you this report.
Inhabitants of the Volta Basin mostly depend on lake transportation for their social and economic activities. However, response to efforts made over the years to ensure that operators and passengers adhere to safety measures have not been encouraging. At Tepa Abatuase in the Biakoye district of the Volta region, aside the issue of improper loading of passengers and goods onto boats, insufficient supply of life jackets is overlooked by most passengers. Some years ago, the Ghana Maritime Authority introduced life jackets to boat owners and operators to ensure safety on the Volta Lake. In an interview, the Director General of the Ghana Maritime Authority, Reverend Dr. Isa Kapita Zuma, bemoaned the fact that people do not see the usefulness of a life jacket.
We are saying that, look, don't abuse the use of these things. Use them for the purpose of which it is. And besides, The moment you drop into the water, you may not know where you drop. You drop into the water in the middle of the lake. No matter how best you can swim, no matter how donkey or King Kong you are, you will not get to ashore. You will die.
In a bid to ensure safety on the lake, the Ghana Maritime Authority has trained boat operators and outboard motor mechanics on safety and basic seamanship. And also, because of recalcitrant boat operators, the authority in collaboration with the Ghana Navy has positioned naval task forces at major boat stations to enforce boat safety measures as well as prevent boats from sailing in the night. As part of activities to commemorate World Maritime Day 2016 dubbed Shaping Indispensable to the World at Tepa Botwase, the Ghana Maritime Authority presented free licenses and roadworthy certificates to boat owners and operators who have registered their boats. For GBC24, Ofeyiwa Dakon reporting.
Medical practitioners say most heart-related conditions and deaths could be prevented through simple everyday activities. Ghana on 1st October 2016 joined the rest of the world to observe World Heart Day with a call on all to make wellness a priority.
Regular exercises, periodic checks with a doctor, proper eating habits, weight control, check of the numbers such as cholesterol, sugar, blood pressure and a host of other activities are some very simple but practical ways of keeping the heart in check. But as simple as these are, heart-related diseases and deaths are on the increase.
People should regularly do health checks. In this country, we don't actually walk in yearly and we say we just want to assess ourselves and know our numbers. But we as much as possible try or do our best to check our cars. Walk into the hospital and say, look, I'm doing an annual check. I want to know my blood sugar. I want to know my blood pressure. I want to know my cholesterol. I want to know my weight. Am I overweight? What is my BMI? All these constitute the risk factors that can something can happen to you within 10 years.
Figures from the World Health Organization reviewed research in September 2016 indicates that the total deaths caused by cardiovascular diseases stands at 17.5 million as at 2012, with a quarter of that number happening in low and middle income countries, including Ghana.
We should slow down on the sugary products. We should slow down on the processed foods. Move your heart to do exercises. Regularly, you must always do exercise of about 30 minutes a day walk. At least 3 times or 5 times a week. A lot of people are just like couch potato. They sit down with television and sometimes by the time they realize, instead of watching the TV is watching them because they fall asleep very fast, just little after meals. We should avoid those kind of sedentary lives.
According to Dr. Abdul Samed Tanku of the National Cardiothoracic Center at the Kulebu Teaching Hospital, the numbers are likely to increase. A Ghanaian comedian who is championing a healthy heart by all, Derek Kobina Boni, known in showbiz as DKB, cautioned people about behavioral change.
We have this funny adage of so we keep because out of every 10 deaths in Ghana, 6 of them are heart related. Six are heart related. Are you among the 6? Check yourself. Diabetes, hypertension, heart attack, other stroke, all sort of things. Just heart, ordinary heart that you need to take care of. How do you do that? You eat a lot of greens, fruits, water, exercise, cut alcohol, cut smoking. You will be fine. Exercising should be a part of us. I entreat each and every Ghanaian to have a skipping rope at home.
Mr. Boni advised politicians to get their hearts checked regularly, especially during political seasons. This year's observation of World Hearts was under the theme, Power Your Heart.
The increase in human activities as well as infrastructural development around the ministry's enclave and its environs have necessitated the siting of fire station in the area to ensure safety in the event of fire outbreak. The fire station brings to 27 the number of stations commissioned by the Ghana National Fire Service since October last year in a bid to bring fire safety closer to the people.
Are the ministry's enclave due to human activities and expansion of structures make the area prone to fire disasters. It is for this reason that Ghana Fire has put up a fire station to provide fire rescue and evacuation services for both workers and visitors. The facility brings to 27 the number of fire stations provided by the Ghana National Fire Service to ensure fire safety in every community. The head of civil service, Nana Ijikum Dramina, said efforts are underway to decongest the ministry's enclave by removing all obstructions to allow free movement to facilitate the work of the fire service. The chief fire officer, Dr. Albert Brangazi, said the threat to fire safety has increased due to globalization and technology. He therefore called for regular simulation exercises to be conducted in all public facilities.
You're watching News Hour live on GBC24, your own news channel on GTV. Go for a quick break. We'll be back shortly. To stay with us.
Hey, sir. Was the sound of the victory train when it made a stop in the nation's capital, the Greater Accra region, where JM and the NDC brought their message of transformation to communities like Kweku Panfu, Botiano, Weja, Bawe, Anya, Soto, Akwetema, Osu, Adabraka, Makola, Tutu, Agbogboloshi, Abose Okai, Dashi, Kaneshi, Kokombe, Dakuma, and Fadama. Cheers, horns, and songs of victory herald John Dramani Mahama as the man of victory 2016 when the people in one accord chanted JN Twasu.
NDC. Ezu. Ezaza.
Time to talk some sports. The University of Ghana has organized a swimming open invitational competition, DART Legon Swimming Open Competition 2016. This was the maiden event. The competition is aimed at promoting swimming as a sport and a healthy lifestyle.
The University of Ghana Sports Directorate, in collaboration with the University of Ghana Swim Club, organized its first swimming open invitational tourney. The Legon Swim Club, known as the Legon Sharks, were joined by clubs including the Lincoln Lions, Ombi Swim Club, the Central Regional Swimming Team, Anopafins, Ghana Dolphins, and the Ghana White Sharks, among others. They competed for laurels in the 200 meters medley relay, 50 meters butterfly, 50 meters backstroke, 200 meters individual medley, 50 meters freestyle, 50 meters breaststroke, and 200 meters freestyle relay. The president of the Legon Swimming Club, Dr. Richmond Aite, was happy at the level of competitiveness.
I think it's been fantastic. We have seven clubs here and they are all doing very well. And we are seeing even performance from others that is improving, you know, and really that's what we want to see. This is the first event we are hosting, but we are going to do this every year. So this is Legon Swimming Competition 2016. Look out for 2017 and beyond.
The director of sports at the University of Ghana, Legon, Dr. Bella Bello Bintugu, expressed satisfaction at the turnout.
I'm very, very happy and very excited. This is the first time, yes, but the patronage is so encouraging and we want to make it a permanent event.
Prizes were presented to deserving swimmers at the various categories.
And in entertainment, the Western Regional Center for National Culture has organized a festival of arts and culture to promote peace and unity in the upcoming general elections. The event was organized to encourage religious and political party leaders as well as traditional authorities to bring their minds together and help promote peace in the country.
Yeah.
The colorful festival of arts and culture held at the forecourt of the Center for National Culture brought together queen mothers, chiefs, religious leaders, students and heads of some institutions at 2nd D. The Nananum Cultural Troupe, OB Cultural Troupe and Biserade Dancing Group put up performances to illustrate how religious and political party leaders should unite to promote peace and development. The Western 40s and Takwa Youth Choir sang patriotic songs to demonstrate the need for peace and love throughout the election period and beyond. Although a company has been contracted to renovate the Center for National Culture, the place has been left to its fate. The director of the center, Mr. Steven Sedefua, called on government to ensure that a contractor working on the facility is investigated.
The late Dr. Kwame Nkrumah built the art centers, now the cultural centers, so that the youth will learn about their culture even if their parents are busy chasing after money. Yet, for 6 years, my honorable minister, the contractor on the Twin City Cultural Center is lost in action. I therefore appeal to Nananum here gathered and the honorable ministers here to kindly work towards the completion of the 2nd Takwari Cultural Center.
The Deputy Western Regional Minister, Mr. Alfred Kojan, spoke about the need for Ghanaians to be patriotic and avoid any negative behavior that could cause tension during and after the elections. The Minister of Tourism, Culture and Creative Arts, Mrs. Elizabeth Ofosuejari, underlined the need to use art and culture to promote peace. She outlined a number of programs that the ministry has started to project the cultural values of the country.
My ministry is currently providing facilities at Nzulezu to make the attraction more appealing to tourists as well as make life for those living in that community more comfortable. For the first time in their history, we are putting up a lot of toilet facilities for both tourists and the locals. We are also doing a nice walkway for them. We have formed a cultural troupe from the indigents. We have trained them, provided costumes and drums, so that your visit to Nzulezu will be worth your while.
The festival afforded participants the opportunity to reflect on the need to promote a culture of peace for national unity and socio-economic development.
But before we take leave of you, a look at the stories which made headlines today. The chiefs and people of Juje are in the Ketu North constituency have celebrated their annual Juje Bazaar. President Mahama, who was the guest of honor, used the occasion to indicate government preparedness to make Juje an oil palm hub in the country. The Ghana Maritime Authority has attributed loss of life from boat accidents on the Volta Lake to refusal of passengers to wear life jackets. According to the authority, many lives can be saved in such boat disasters if the boat operators and passengers wear life jackets. That's all in this package. Thanks for your company. Talking Point is next.